Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna be taking a look at the new Pharaonic Legend pack. Apparently there's gonna be this card over here and it's super broken. I just saw a lot of people tweeting about it saying how broken this card is, and on top of that we got a new V-Jump card to check out. But let's check out this like broken card first, or supposedly. All right, so the Pharaonic Legend pack, I don't know when we're getting the TCG, but at least in the OCG it's gonna be, the order period is May 20th to June 21st. So we're not going to get this for a long time in the OCG, which means we might not get this until like very, very late in TCG, like fall. But anyways, the first 50,000 packs will be delivered 1 week after being ordered. Okay, they can only be ordered via PC and smartphones can't be used to order these. I don't know, whatever. Let's check out the effects. That's what matters. Because we all know we're going to be on EDO playing these anyways. Pharaonic Advent is a new level 8 dark spellcaster effect monster, and here is the artwork on it. 2000 attack, 2000 defense points, and says that you can only use the first and third effects of this card's name each once per turn. The first part of the effect is to tribute one monster to sparse summon this card from your hand. Okay, so easy summon condition. The second part gains 300 attack for each continuous trap on the field and in the graveyards. The third effect is you can tribute one fairy, fiend, or reptile monster to add one continuous trap from your deck to your hand. Also, you cannot spawn some monsters for the rest of this turn. So, this effect is actually pretty dang good. Obviously, if with the Ogdo, any like reptile variant, you do have a lot of fodder to tribute. So this is going to be a pretty easy condition. So how is this broken? Maybe the other support is supposed to make it broken. Next up, though, we have, oh, new Gravekeeper support. Okay, that was kind of surprising. I was expecting more like reptile. This is a really weird, like, I guess these are all like Egyptian themed cards. I mean, that's what the Pharaonic Legend is. So anyways, this is Gravekeeper's engraving. Here's the artwork. Looks like a normal spell card that has like three different effects. So it says, at the start of your main phase, apply one of these effects to both players until the end of your opponent's turn. So they can't activate cards or effects in the graveyard, which Nectar Valley already pretty much does. They can't banish it. So basically like a Necro Valley. And then the other one is, so they can't activate card effects in the graveyard. They can't banish cards from the graveyard. And the other effect is they cannot special summon monsters from the graveyard. Okay, so this can actually be a pretty good card, because you can activate this and basically make it so they can't maybe use certain hand traps against you. I think this card definitely has some potential for certain decks. Even though it's like a Gravekeeper's card, it does have Gravekeeper in text, so I guess you can maybe have some synergy with it. But being able to stop special summons from the graveyard, this is definitely a good side deck card for potential players, or even main decking it just so they can't like, you know, call by the grave, they can't like banish. This card definitely has some potential. Anyways, next up, this card over here is Apophis the Swamp Deity, which is a continuous trap card that says, during the main phase, special summon this card as a normal monster, reptile, earth, level 6, attack and defense are 2000 each. This card is also still a trap. Then you can negate the effects of all face-up cards your opponent controls up to the number of other continuous traps you control until the end of this turn. Okay, I see what people are saying, why this card is super, super broken now. So basically, this card has no restrictions, right? It just has to tribute a reptile, and then it's any. It doesn't say like you can't already have the card on the field or in the graveyard. So what it comes down to, if you can set this up. Now, is it really broken? I think people are kind of overhyping it, because like I said, I saw a couple people tweeting about this over on Twitter and saying like this card is absolutely broken. You keep in mind, it is other, so this one won't count itself. So it's just not like you could just go summon this and negate one, right? Because it is other, up to the number of other continuous trap cards. So yeah, you can negate a bunch of things, but it's at one interval, if that makes any sense. But then you could, I guess, tribute the card and then go for another one, but it still would have to be wait. I think people are overhyping this. Is it broken or overhyped? I really don't think it's that broken. I mean, that's my personal opinion. You gotta be fast in Yu-Gi-Oh! Waiting a turn for a trap is not that insane, but there might be some other uses. I haven't played any of the Ogdo, like Snake Deity variants in so long. They did get recent support, like, I don't know, maybe from last year, but not like really recent support, but I think it's overhyped. But we still got another card. This is the new promotional V-Jump card, Cardan the Great Sage. So here's the artwork. Looks like it's an Earth level 4, 1400 attack, 1100 defense points, and it's going to be an Earth Fairy effect monster. Okay, so is this supposed to be like its own archetype? Because it seems like it almost might be. Anyways, it says when this card is normal summon, you get to set a continuous trap from your hand or your graveyard. It can be activated this turn. Okay, so only when this card is summoned do you get that effect. Okay, if you could like call the haunted and then put that would be a lot better. Second part of the effect is if this card is sent to the graveyard, you can make all face-up traps you currently control become unable to be destroyed by opponent's card effects until the end of the next turn. Okay, that's like a usable effect. I guess it's like for continuous scrap cards, like some Egyptian stuff. I don't know. I still don't vote that it is broken OP, but that's what people are talking about right now in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community with the Pharaonic Legend pack, with the super boss monster. I mean, like, it comes out at like 2K, and you'll probably have at least like 2 to 3, so it's like 2,600, 2,900. It's really not that great. I think it's overhyped. Anyways, thanks for tuning in, guys. If you guys enjoyed the video, though, let me know your thoughts down below, but drop a like on it if you're new here and you want to keep up to date with more new Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and so you don't miss out on newer cards coming out in Legendary Pharaonic Pack when it does come out. But take care. I'll catch you in the next video. I'm out. Peace.